The focus. I forgot about all that. Redo.
That looks good.
That looks good?
Yeah.
Let's do one more just in case.
Sarah, you're in the shot.
I'm sorry.
Move your body.
Sorry.
All right, one more.
That looked awesome.
Did it? Montage begin. No. Oh. Stepped outside in the freaking cold ice, my foot. Annyeong, welcome to another day. Sarah and I are at this winter wonderland. We went here last year. And that one was a complete travesty. Actually, there's a lot of good and bad. We hung out for the first time out of town. We got like this awesome vacation in, but the lights turned off. We lost electricity, and basically everything sort of went downhill for the guy running the event. But round two this year, we're at a place that isn't as crazy. There's no blizzards apparently here, but we're a little more secluded, and we're at a place with like a lot of electricity. A lot of people who are really good at certain crafts teaching workshops for people who are interested, and people fly from all over the world to come here and learn. And I'll probably be spending most of the time, I don't know, secluded in my room on the internet.
Hey, are you Sarah?
Yes.
Hey, Sarah, good. Nice to meet you.
That's a lot of people. I'm gonna head back to the room and like take a nap.
Pretty crazy adventures getting in. I know Aiden took a lift.
We ran over a stop sign.
It's very clear who's the vlogger here.
My man Craig Adams is teaching a class on YouTube if you've signed up for that. That is now in a room called...
Right off the bat, I just want to say that I met someone who designed the website for Stance, and I think he said Oakley as well, and I was like, what? Lots of designers here. Yeah, he was just crushed the game, but he also recognized me for my YouTube channel, which is really cool, and I was like, yo, I like your channel. And then once he started explaining what he did, I was intimidated. How do I get out there?
Go out the door.
Oh, right, okay.
There's a place inside my head. There'll be things I've never seen.
It's really actually not that cold at all outside, and I feel like the only way that I'll be able to ride my skateboard, the only way that I want to ride my skateboard out here, especially with all the snow and the wetness, now as I was saying, exercise is very limited, especially when there's snow all over the place. I'm gonna carpet skate. Let me know if I'm distracting you, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Blah, 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 blah.
Chillin'.
For some reason, my brain is still on the trampoline.
Oh!
Ooh.
Dang it.
I'm already sweating. I did like three tricks.
Ooh.
I got half. Oh, wait,
yeah.
Ooh, there. That's the effort.
Oh. Ooh.
But why does my foot go so?
You gotta be conscious of it.
Whoa.
Okay. That was straight up a body V. Oh. What's up with your stupid front foot?
I don't know.
Ooh, there we go. You stepped off, but there we go. Ooh, a little more extra scoop on that.
Ugh.
When you playing with the sharks, this is what you. Oh. Oh, I got that. Babe, I kind of didn't get it. Oh my gosh, first try. You came up from the computer and just dropped it first try like that for the boys? Switch?
Oh, that was a perfect one.
Ooh. That's my dog right there, bro. We out in the streets.
Oh, God. Oh.
This is getting kinky.
I know.
Invisible presence of all the creatures.
Is there a special arrival coming from the sky? Of course. This event has been amazing so far, and they just popped off and hooked us up with some fat merch. Now it looks like somewhat of an edible t-shirt. Mmm, delicious.
Lunch! Lunch! Lunch!
There's something way more important over here.
Is this tic-tac-toe?
No, is this tic-tac-toe?
Tic-tac-toe.
Ooh. Oh my. Oh wait, you need more. Are we not supposed to be in here? Okay,
I will leave. Yeah, oh, you don't have to shoot us in the face.
Walking like a boss, walking like a boss. Look at her, walking like a mother boss.
Yo, what's up, man?
Super fan.
How are you, man?
Should we get food?
No.
Oh my god. Y'all both started to instantly date.
This is actually kind of the worst situation that's ever happened. There's four people with cameras.
All of you.
Remember earlier when I went outside? It wasn't that bad. Now, look at this fog that has taken over the lands. So what's happening is that we are going outside to take breaks from all the work of us just sitting in the room. We basically go get lunch, we got breakfast, and we're about to get dinner, but I'm just realizing that Nyjah Houston's new part comes out in like 20 minutes. Which means
we're gonna watch Nyjah's part right this second.
Okay, back 50, pop out. Oh my god! You hear him breathing? This guy dies a lot, by the way. Oh gosh.
Dude, there's so many angles on
that. I know. It's crazy when he does like an insane banger then does another one. Same spot, same day. Crazy. That shirt is insane.
Nuh-uh.
Jesus.
Wow.
Ooh, this rail's so scary.
What?
I've never seen him do that trick. He does the best trick on that gnarliest rail.
That, and it was so steep.
Yeah. And like, car.
Oh, those are shitty. How sick do you think he thought he was when he was just like walking across that bridge?
With that 10 million paycheck for a 3-year contract.
Wow. Those look like shoes that normal people would wear.
Right. I think that's what, yeah, Nike's good at the middle ground. Gosh.
Wow. Where is that?
Oklahoma Bay. Oh no, this is the infamous. Oh my god, that shirt. Whoa!
That was his pee-pee wiener. His
pee-pee wiener. So now he's just laying on the ground. That's what happens when you fall like that, I guess. Oh, there's blood involved, so he must have hit his head. That's not his blood.
I love how epic this montage is. The filmer's like, okay, stay still for a little bit longer. I gotta go get my crane, my gimbal.
He's like, can we please go to the hospital? That's what would happen if I tried to skate that rail. 100%.
He literally looks like he's 30. I can't believe he's, what, 24?
Yeah, something like that. Switch front feet with Hollywood 16. That is, like, not real.
What is he gonna do on this?
I don't know. Believe in himself?
Oh, you're kidding.
Oh my god.
How is that even possible?
Well, look at the rail! How- Ah! Okay, that makes sense.
Oh, that was so not graceful.
And he got so far. He's like, got past the hard part. Ah!
Dude.
The sound.
Props to this dude. Oh my god, these shots of him just like laying down. Are you kidding me?
Now just stay there for another 10 seconds. Here it is.
Does he have a mom? I know his dad is crazy, but I can
Yeah, his mom, like, I think they have a good relationship.
I can only imagine her watching this.
I know.
You know?
Dude, Jesus.
Ooh.
Ooh, he's coming in.
Mm-hmm.
God.
Whoa, I've never seen that before.
That's not a thing that anyone does.
Little twirl twirl?
Oh, with the security guard there. These rails, what is he trying to do?
I've never seen these rails before, like in real life.
I
didn't know they existed.
My theory is like he's trying to die, but he just keeps.
Sorry, I'm oh my god. Can we just talk about like all the gear he's repping? Like a new Nike shirt every clip?
Yeah. What the actual ball sack? Switch 50. That's switch. That's backwards. That's naked. What? With the ball. Oh! In your ugly face, boy! He's probably kind of pretty. He's dead. No, he's good, he's good. He come the real, he bout to drop that little hammy, huh? Not in those ground, not that all snot. That was in the magazine, that's so crazy. Gee, freaking. What?
ragdoll.
Kickflip 50, that freaking rail. Are you joshing me? Oh god, Nolly Hill knows what. I knew. I just guessed.
You got him.
Wow, that's really impressive. I'm not gonna lie to you. I usually do lie.
These shots are like...
so good.
Yeah.
Jeez. Literally just goes on forever. He's still grinding to this day. Oh my god, what's he doing? No, she didn't.
Oh, he stays on it.
Oh my god. No.
Can you imagine if they like missed the shot? Like,
that's probably why he has six cameramen per shot. Dude, are you seriously joking me right now? With a monster hat? Yeah, they call me Nyjah.
Is that the last trick?
It's a whole different sphere of skating though. That's like the daredevil type of skating where it's like you basically, you up the ante in gnarliness rather than maybe upping the ante in like tech, even though he does. He's better than everyone. Right. I'm just saying, like, you can get, like, you can be really creative and innovative without jumping down big giant stuff.
Right.
But he's the dude who's gonna, like, push it that direction, like, super.
You know what? From the wise words of Zac Efron from High School Musical, he push it to the limit, limit. My link is in the
oh
bio.
Oh my god, that hurt.
It's fine.
It did hurt, didn't it? Okay, I'm back to the room right now. I have work I gotta get done. I gotta leave in like 20 minutes to go see the talk with Dan Petty. And the thing is, I do wanna make a summary video of this entire trip. I wanna show like a fun montage and be like, epicurrents, make sure you come here next year because the event is awesome. But I wanna create basically a resume for future brand deals. Now, I've done a decent amount of brand deals actually, especially via Instagram. If you see a post that says ad or anything like that, that's a brand deal. And the truth is, the brand deals is how Sarah and I and a lot of YouTubers live. Who is willing to pay this much money for the brand deals? And then I realized pretty much everyone. So it's a slippery slope. One time I was hit up by McDonald's and I'm a vegan and I'm not trying to sit here and be like, McDonald's is the worst thing in the world, but I couldn't do the brand deal. And then there are other people who have hit me up where I'm like, it's so not on brand that I can't do it. Anyways, I never really portray this part of the videos because I do brand deals on my channel as well. I've done the Squarespace ones that you guys have seen in the past, and usually I just say thank you for sponsoring this video because I appreciate it. And then some are a little more extensive. So I wanna let you guys in on the behind the scenes of what a lot of people don't tell you. And one thing is I'm working on a brand deal right now. I'm actually working on a brand deal that's gonna be promoted through Instagram and Snapchat, which I never use. So a lot of my day is actually spent dedicated to this. It's actually like doing a real job. Again, you have to think of the creative direction that you want it to go, and you basically have to be like the director, the producer of a commercial for these brands. It's such an interesting facet, and at the end of the day, I will tell you this, if you are someone who is more interested in money, that's when making quality content pays off. But YouTube itself doesn't really push videos that are really well made and beautiful and pretty like they would be on Vimeo. On YouTube, it's more about the rawness and the realness of the footage itself, but you have to fight that balance. You have to figure out, will my content be accessible for brands and will it also grow my channel at the same time? And I'm just bringing this up because there are a lot of people out there who do sit on that balance. They're just like, should I just be crazy and ridiculous and obnoxious and try to get as many views as possible, or should I create this masterpiece and potentially not get any views? And I will say financially, in the long run, what I've seen is that doing these brand deals where I put more effort into making it higher quality and prettier have paid off financially a lot better. But when it comes to YouTube, those videos won't be seen as much. The funny thing is I made a video for the Buffer Festival, which is basically us premiering our talents as a filmmaker. And my video was extremely well received with the crowd. Everyone was clapping, they were stoked. And Peter McKinnon even approached me and said, yo, your video was the best video out of the lot. I'm just completely bragging right now and I'm sorry about that. I have a point. The point is that video on my YouTube channel did not do that well because my content isn't centered around making the highest quality format. It's centered around skateboarding and just having fun. Anyways, long rants, but the main message is if you're someone who gets really bummed out after working a long time on a video and you're like, this is the best video, it's so well done, I worked really hard on it, continue to hone that craft, continue to upload videos like that, continue to make videos that you like to watch.
Because at the end of the day, that's what's gonna make the most impact to you internally, and it could even potentially lead to a more financial success on this platform. Anyways, that's my advice, and I wanna say, as a YouTuber, my main job isn't being a YouTuber anymore. It's being a content creator for brands. That's something that I'd never really thought of myself in being in a position to do, and YouTube has wrapped me around the world to that point. Guys, see you tomorrow for another video, probably. I don't know how consistent I'll be doing these, but I'm gonna be trying my damnedest to do them as consistent as possible. I love you so much. Progress daily. And keep
warm.
Killing it!